In this video, we're going to be talking about optional chaining. Easily one of my most favorite things about the new ECMAScript. I can't believe how long we lived without this. Optional chaining looks like this question mark period. Before I get into what exactly optional chaining is, I'm going to show you where this is relevant to you. So say we have an object, and this object has several nested levels. So you see this object has one level, two levels, three levels into it. If we wanted to access one of those levels, we would say incident record.incident.details.description, etc. And even more complex if one of those things were an array, because then we would have to know their index and that's etc. etc. So this is long. One of the problems inside old school JavaScript is, what if you're getting an object from an external source or an API or an integration, and their objects are huge, especially in APIs, or they may change the API in the background and now your script might error out? What if this description didn't exist? Or what if they changed the name of an earlier level like incident? Now this wouldn't run. So let's simulate that. Let's say they changed this to incidents. And now if I run the script, I actually get a full error. It actually stops my script from running. Now I have a broken script, and this might be a critical function to my needs. One of the ways that we used to safeguard against that was this very tedious if incident record and incident record incident and incident record incident dot details. This is how a lot of us used to safeguard against one of these situations where an object changed and now we are lost within it. So if I press run now, nothing happens because one of those objects were missing. We actually verify that those things exist before we actually run it. This is tedious. So in the new ECMAScript, that syntax is so much easier with optional chaining. All we have to do, if we're not sure if a particular level might not be there, or they might return null or undefined, is simply add optional chains. And I'm adding them to each level here because in the situation where this object is coming from an external source, I want to make sure that my code still runs, even if something inside of here fails. So if I press run on this script, it returns undefined instead. Before, it was a complete error and my entire script shut down. Instead, it's giving me undefined and my script continues to run to the end. Very useful, especially in things like in the service portal, where you have an input object that needs to go back into your server script as a data object. Verifying if that input variable is still there or even exists is much easier when you use optional chaining. And similarly, if I add a function here to this object, optional chaining can be used in the calling of that function. There's the correct response. If I change the name of that function, undefined instead of an error. Nice.